Hey guys, Neil here, and I'm going to do a little preview before the Titans-Jaguars epic battle on Thursday Night Football. 2-2-13 teams, 2-12 teams, trying to battle for it to be 2-14 end of season with that number one, number two, number three-ish overall pick, hopefully. Jacksonville will probably trade instead of drafting a quarterback, but that's for another time. Okay. I want to look at number 99, Sen'Derrick Marks. He has three plays in the Cleveland-Jacksonville game earlier this year that I do want to just highlight and talk about why he will be fun to watch tomorrow night. Now, I know, no one cares. And only people are really caring, I guess I should say no one. If you're a Jets fan, I guess you care. If you're a Raiders fan, I guess you care. If you're a Bucks fan, I guess you care. Because you're looking to get that high draft pick. So, let's just get right into Sen'Derrick Marks, number 99. He's sitting in a three technique right here. I have a little boom, yellow, right here. Boom, ha, crushing face. So, it's not working. He's going to come off. This is what I like about players that struggle sometimes when they get double teamed, is that they look for right at the quarterback's eyes. Now, he's clearly double-teamed. Now, this is pretty standard pass protection. They're going to double-team that three technique and push the pass coverage, or excuse me, pass protection to the outside. That way that you can kind of create a better pocket. You don't want any pressure out the middle. That's kind of what's taught. And the quarterback's going to float to the right. He knows that's where his double-team is. Hopefully, this man can stay strong. He can ride him out. And again, he can ride him out. And quarterback's going to have a lane to throw the ball, or potentially run if they're more of a mobile quarterback. Marks recognizes this. Hey, don't fight against the double team. That's one thing you're taught. Just don't fight against it. You have to either dip down through it, go to the ground if they're run blocking, or settle. And Marks decides to settle. I mean, that's a lazier decision sometimes, but look where his eyes are. Straight in the quarterback. He's not trying to defeat the guy in front of him. Now he's trying to disrupt the play through the eyes of a quarterback. Now, quarterback sees an open man. Marks times his jump. Easy bat. Listen, I know. We see these things. Hey, he's just standing at the line of scrimmage. Yeah, he was. A little cherry picking. But he recognized the situation, recognized the double team, recognized that, hey, I got one chance to make a play here. Hopefully the ball goes in the middle of the field. I can help a linebacker out. That's what he does. On to play number two in our second quarter. And it is at the 12:39 mark. Is that right? I feel like this isn't right. Let's see. Okay, we have Marks playing, looks like 2-eye, head up. We're going to get a better look. Again, batted ball. Nice recognition. Here he is. Yeah, he's playing 2-eye. So, I don't like this hand on the hip, by the way. It bothers me. Just saying. Comes off the ball. I guess he was a little slow there, look. But he's attacking the inside shoulder. We got kind of a push protection. They're kind of sliding, it looks like, almost. It's like a three-step drop protection where they ride out the ends and will zone block it. You know, words escape me right now, but just slide protection. Marks goes for a swim. He basically beats his man, then gets held pretty bad here. Again, recognition, eyes on quarterback, reacting, great timing on the jump, smash in your face. Now the next play here, this is both those, by the way, are third down plays. Just done out there. High leverage situations. Excuse me. 9:24. Okay. Look at that, Marks. Look at the get off here. Watch this destruction of the right guard. This is just downright beat the living hell out of the guy in front of you. That's what you're looking for out of a defensive tackle. Now, we have an over formation. Let's back this up just a second. Over formation is Now, in the NFL, you don't get too much because teams will adjust a little much. But you have guard, you have tackle, you have tight end, and you have a potential crack block. Look how tight this wide receiver is. A traditional over is a wing that will be off the ball here. But with tight like this, we could see, you know, where heel down block, heel crack here. He pulls around, kicks out here. Is this what they play? Is that what they run? No, they run zone. But you can get that down, pull and kick out. And this down block here is really brutal because it's crack block. And sometimes safeties' eyes are looking here instead of looking at the wide receiver. And the wide receiver kind of wants to do it, but they run zone. We get a seam, actually. We're kind of getting a seam because this right guard has been destroyed. So the seam's really non-existent. Line of scrimmage, kind of see the rest of the offensive line kind of pushing it. Marks hasn't moved, and now his legs start getting into him. Look at his hand placement. Inside shoulder pads. Offense tackle's outside, so he's one leverage in the inside. Leg drive, shoves the man off him, bench press him, and then just, there you go, easy tackle. Do this a little bit closer. We're just watching Marks. So again, playing that 3-tech, and he pushes the gap too. He's not really covering. This is almost what we would call like a 3-eye, where he's just in the gap. This is a gap player. This isn't even really. He's not playing a 4, and he's not playing really a 3. He's in the gap. So this is a Gus Bradley special, and you kind of wonder if this central crack, so he could, if he tries to pull, you know, this is kind of the adjustment where if he tries to pull, he's already in the gap. It's going to make it harder for him to actually get out there. And any type of back block is non-existent now. So you would have to almost pull this guy to get around, and that's just never happening on a play that far outside. So they, you know, it's going to be tough for these two to get to these two. Than him to cut him off. It's just, you know, makes it a lot more difficult, him sitting in gap. So I wonder if that's the adjustment. I mean, just his get-off right there is incredible. Well, I tell the other defensive linemen to react. They read zone immediately. They're going with the zone. Try to protect your gaps to the outside. Make sure there's no cutback leans. We have 91 engaging upfield, reacting to it. That's how you have to do it with a safety down in the box and a crack block potential. Because if you go soft, you can get cracked. And that's not going to be fun. This right here is what makes this play. Because you have a running lane, maybe. Running back versus linebacker. You know, could work out for you. That bench press off is incredible. I love it. I'll watch one more time at full speed. That bench press is just awesome. Just awesome. So 3-tech, tack, push, bench press, TFL. Whew, that's beautiful stuff. All right, so, hey, well, I'm looking for Marks. I'm looking for guys who can get the ball quick. I'm sorry. But I'm looking for guys who can get the ball quick. I'm looking for a guy that is really going to get his hands inside, great placement, and overall just winning his one-versus-ones. So how often are you going to double-team him? How often are you going to bring a guy, a running back, to fill during a pass play where they're looking just at Marks? Because of his threat on his pass rush. So, you know, it's going to be interesting. That's what I'm going to be watching. So, hope you enjoy the video. Guys, hopefully I get a few more out and next week as Christmas break begins. But, hey, try and enjoy games once you can. You know, Jet fans, Bucks fans, good luck, sirs. Take it easy, boys.